Good morning, gentlemen. And today we are going to discuss about the breakdown maintenance of pump, centrifugal pump. In the previous lab, we discussed about the preventive maintenance of pumps. So there mainly you can classify it into three types of maintenance. One is preventive maintenance, then next one is breakdown maintenance, and then predictive maintenance. In your syllabus course outline, there is a chapter called breakdown maintenance also. So that's why I will explain how breakdown maintenance can be done on a pump. And this is very important. Breakdown means what? When the pump becomes damaged and they cannot operate, no more we cannot start the, we can operate, we cannot use it for any operation. That's why the breakdown. For example, car, when you break down, you cannot again continue driving. Same thing here also, pump also, you cannot pump liquids. That's why breakdown, the breakdown. So that means you need to take it to the, suppose a pump is in a plant, like a Qatar Gas or a QP or Shell, and when pump is breakdown, then what they do is they take it to the workshop. And that here, this is the, for example, this is the equipment pump. This is the motor and this is the centrifugal pump. We took it from the plant, for example, we took it from the workshop. This is the workshop. And then the workshop, we prepare the work order. And from the, by using the work order, we do the repair and maintenance. So this is the workshop. And we prepare the work order. And then after that, we need to dismantle the parts. So we don't care about the motor, because motor is okay. And only we are going to do the breakdown maintenance of the pump side. So one more time I explain. This is suction side. And this is suction pipe. The flange is coming to the, this is suction and it is discharge. I told you before also suction, the pipe is big, diameter is big, here the small, this is small. This is connected to the pipeline by means of flange. You can see so many holes here. And there will be a gasket here, and also there will be a gasket here and a pipe and for discharge. This is the oiled casing, and then inside the casing there will be impeller. And then there will be here, you can see the mechanical seal in the stuffing box here. This mechanical seal, majority of the pumps in the plant, you can see mechanical seal, because it is very efficient and no leak, and it can run for 1 year, 2 years without any problem, provided the alignment of the motor and the pump is perfect. And this is the bearing housing of the pump, bearing housing of the pump. Here there is a big pump, there is a good, very efficient bearings are there, ball bearing or roller bearings are here inside. That will support the shaft for preventing any vibration and keep the shaft in, on hold and on line. And this is the coupling. That coupling is connected to the motor. So this is the coupling, one coupling here, one coupling here, joined together. And this is a flexible coupling. That's why there is no bolt here. And this is connected to the motor and the pump. So when the motor starts, this will operate. Now coming to the breakdown maintenance. So this is not working so properly. So what we do, we need to take it all the parts. So first we have to remove this bolt. You can see this bolt, foundation bolt of the, from the frame. And this pump is, will be taken to the table, work table. And in the work table, we'll open all these bolts here. These bolts with different spanners and wrenches, maybe socket spanner, ring spanner. Never use the open end spanner, because it can damage the nut head. This nut can be damaged. So you take the bolts, everything, and then you can take the casing out. And once the casing is out, you can remove the impeller. And then you can, after that, you can remove the mechanical seal. And also this cover you can remove, and then you can see the bearing, and take the shaft out, the bearing can be taken out. So you take it out all the parts from the, using these proper spanners and pipe wrenches and socket spanners, etc. Maybe wrenches like a torque wrench or whatever you need, maybe all the tools you need. Sometimes if it is a very heavy pump, you need a small floor crane also, like this floor crane also, maybe if it is too heavy. And with a sling and a slang, shackles, you need to lift the pump and keep it on the table. And on the table, we'll inspect. So we keep the pump casing on the table, and we keep the shaft on the table, we keep the mechanical seal on the table, we keep the bearings on the table, and we take the coupling on the table, and everything, impeller will be keeping on the table, and impeller, that's the gaskets will keep it on the table, impeller nut is there, that all we take it out and keep it on the table. So once we keep all the parts, important parts on the table, what we do is we first clean the parts. Maybe sometimes if too much dirt is there, we need to use some white spirit or diesel for cleaning the parts, sometimes wash with water also. But normally we use the white spirit or diesel for cleaning. Otherwise, they should use water, then there is possibility of some corrosion. So keep washing first. After washing, inspect the parts. If the shaft is bent or some warping is there or some scratch is there, if it is too much beyond repair, we need to replace the shaft. Otherwise, maybe you can use it again by some cleaning and some repair, minor repair by on the lathe machine or something like that. You can reuse it. And check the bearings. If the bearings are maybe damaged, then bearing you need to replace. And sometimes no lubrication, you need to lubricate the bearings. Then check the mechanical seal. Normally mechanical seal, the main problem is mechanical seal maybe might have damaged. Because of that, there is too much liquid coming through the starting box. In that case, you need to replace the, you should analyze the problem, what is the issue with the mechanical seal. Open the parts of the mechanical seal, rotating part and the stationary part. You take it out from the mechanical seal and check, and maybe spring is damaged or some you need lapping of the mechanical seal, maybe, because that is why the leak is coming. So either you can do by near workshop, in the workshop we can do the lapping. And if you cannot do the lapping, then you'll take it to the industry area. There is a company called John Crane. They are the authorized people to repair the mechanical seal. They can do it. And once it is repaired, then we check the impeller, clean the impeller, replace the gasket always, because gasket is might have, you cannot use it again. So once it is cleaned and inspected and replaced the damaged parts and repaired the any other parts which we can do, then we do the reverse, in reverse order, we reassemble the parts like the shaft, impeller, impeller nut, then the mechanical seal, then bearings, everything we put, and also then put the lubrication, it's the lubrication part, and also you can, here there is a place where you can see the quantity of lubricant, it should be above 50%. All those things we should do. Once we do, then we can test the pump. How you test? And before that, you need the alignment. So you can see here, alignment here, this pump and motor should be aligned properly, should be in same line. And using, there are three methods, the alignment can be done. One is using a steel rule, then that is only preliminary and basic, just rough alignment. Second one is remand face alignment, then reverse dial alignment, then laser alignment. In the company plant, most of the companies, they are using laser alignment. And it is very, very accurate also. Alignment is very important, otherwise again, the shaft will bend. And also it can affect the performance of the mechanical steel. So once all these things is done, and we make sure that the testing, after testing, if it is working properly, then what we do is we can hand over the pump and the motor to the plant people. When then they will install it again and they can operate it. That's how the breakdown maintenance is done. So breakdown maintenance means you need to dismantle all the parts of the components of the pump. And then you use a proper tool, you dismantle and keep it on the table and check each and every part clean, and after that you check each and every part, and then you need to replace the gaskets, and also if it is any part which is damaged, need to be can be repaired, you can do repair, or if it is need to be replaced, need to be replaced. And then after that you can reassemble, and then reassemble in reverse order, and then after that you do testing and alignment, everything should be done. That is how the breakdown maintenance is done. Hope you understood. So breakdown maintenance, this is the standard procedure for breakdown maintenance. You need to prepare a work order before that also. This is how we do repair of a centrifugal pump. So we understood this, and breakdown maintenance is very done maybe only if the equipment is out of order, cannot be operated properly, and it cannot work. If it is not working properly, then only we do breakdown maintenance. Thank you so much, and you please refer the lab report and answer the questions, and label the components and everything, and write a brief report on how you can do breakdown maintenance of a central pump. Thank you, and have a good day.